going to sing this chorus two times exactly the way it is. He says, a higher plane than I have found. Instead of where love and joy abound, we put a higher plane than I have found. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. Chorus two times, and we begin to pray. Looking for somebody to tell, please, my flight is in another 20 minutes. please, let me jump this queue so that I can clear in immigration and go. Number one, there was nobody to talk to. And the security people that I found, they didn't even understand what I was saying. It was like, now somebody now told me, take your time, take your turn. You see all these people, they are also going. My flight was 20 minutes. I was counting down. At the end of the day, I missed my flight. In a country where I knew nobody, and I had nowhere to sleep. But that's not the end of my story. So, God's people were there. They paid for my hotel. I slept in hotel in the airport. In the morning, I went out. I got myself my boarding pass before I went. I insisted. In the morning, I said, I will just drop my bag and run to board. And I got there in the morning. I showed them my boarding pass. The queue was long, as usual. And I told them, this is my boarding pass. I want to drop my bag. The woman said, no, you have to queue and take another boarding pass. I said, what? I told her, I said, I missed my flight yesterday because of this. She said, well, you have to take your turn. At that point, I now stood. It suddenly occurred to me that, by the way, you are a child of God. Take authority. So I stood. I said, every power that will not allow me to get to my destination, I command you, die. You will not believe it. It was like immediately the woman just come. She came, the security woman. She said, yes, yes, you are about to miss your flight. Jump to the front. And that was how I made it. Brethren, this is November. You remember we all started from January. Do you remember your prayer points in January? Do you remember your anxiety in January? Do you remember your desire in January? How many delays have you had? That long queue that you have been encountering. But today, this is November. And that testimony has not come. But I want to assure you, as the Lord liveth, it will come. I said, it will come. Therefore, we are going to start with the delay. Whatever power that is causing delay of the promises of God for our lives, they must be dismantled. In the name of Jesus. The Bible tells us in Genesis chapter 8, please give it to us. Genesis chapter 8, verse 22. Genesis chapter 8, verse 22. It says, while the earth remaineth, it says, seed time and harvest. It says, cold and heat, summer and winter, day and night shall not cease. There is no provision for wasted labor here. Can you see it? There is no provision for anything that will not bring reward. There is no provision for a season that will end forever. Therefore, I decree into your life that that season of shame will not last forever. That season of barrenness, it will end today. It will give room to fruitfulness. In the name of Jesus, that storm in your life will give way to peace. 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 Your night time has gone enough. It is your morning of joy. In the name of Jesus. Therefore, we are going to lift up our voices and say, Father, Father, every delay in your promises concerning my life, let them be dismantled today. In the name of Jesus, every obstacle, every form of hindrance, every delay, by whatever name it is called, is it spiritual or physical? Is it medical or emotional? Every delay to every good thing that you have promised, that you have spoken, that you have prophesied into my life, Almighty God, today, let there be an end to it. Let them be dismantled. In the name of Jesus, let them be dismantled. In the name of Jesus, thank you, my Father. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. You remember I told you that I was going to miss my flight the second time. The Bible says in Mark 11:23, he said, all you need to do is to do what? Say unto the mountain, be thou removed and be cast into the sea. He said, if you doubt not, it shall be so to you. Are you here and you have a doctor's report that has told you that your womb cannot carry a baby? I say it is a lie. You are going to decree to that mountain that it must move. That fibroid must move. That thing that is there must move. It must move to make a way for a child to be there. In the name of Jesus, have you been writing applications everywhere? And they are telling you that there is no room for you. Remember, that was what they said concerning Jesus. They said there was no room for him in the inn, the creator of the heaven and the earth. They said that there was no room. But was he born or was he not born? Your miracles shall be born. I say, your miracles shall be born. Your ideas shall be made manifest in the name of Jesus. You will bring forth of that idea in the name of Jesus. You are going to lift up your voice and command that mountain. What is that mountain in your marriage? What is that mountain in your life? You are going to decree into that mountain. Look the mountain eyeball to eyeball and decree and say, Father, Father, I command this mountain, standing against the purpose of God for my life, I command you to move, move, move in the name of Jesus. Begin to tell the Lord, the year is rolling to an end. All your promises must come to pass. All your purposes must be fulfilled. Everything that represents mountain, that is standing against your purpose for my life, Father, roll them away. Roll them away in the name of Jesus. Father, roll them away. Every closed womb must be restored. Ah, Almighty God, restore our dashed hope. Every hope that has turned hopeless, Christ in us is the hope of glory. Every dashed hope be restored in the name of Jesus. Every closed womb be opened in the name of Jesus. Every perverted destiny be restored in the name of Jesus. Every stormy sea in which we are going through, receive calm in the name of Jesus. Almighty God, let every broken mountain that is standing against our place of destination, our hope, our goal in life, let them be rolled away. Roll them away. In the name of Jesus, our season, holy by shakerable, must go. It must come to pass. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, our Father. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Finally, before we sit down, you remember in that same Genesis 8:22, he says, seed time and harvest. And he says, cold and heat, summer and winter. God is a God of seasons and times. He does not stop. Any power that will not allow us to enter into our season of harvest, to enter into our season of rest. Do you know that there are some people, it is when they ought to have their peace. They have been sending children to school. They have been paying the school fees. Then it is time to sit back and enjoy the fruits of their labor. That is when sickness will come. That is when death will come. Today we are going to stand against it. We are going to say, no, that is not the plan and purpose concerning our life. We are going to lift up our voice and say, Father, Father, every power that is contending with my season of fruitfulness, my season of rest, my season of harvest, Father, begin to contend with them. In the name of Jesus, we receive our freedom this morning from every power that is contending with our season of harvest. Almighty God, every power that is contending with our times of rest. Almighty God, Father, begin to contend with them. In the name of Jesus, begin to contend with them. All in the name of Jesus, even if we, with our eyes open, we enter into it. Lord Almighty, today, you promise us that thus saith the Lord. Lord, every power that is standing against our fruitfulness, Jesus, our season of rest, every power contending with our season of fruitfulness. When a woman gets married, she's supposed to have children. Whatever power that is standing against such in our midst, Father, arise today and begin to contend with them. All our oppressors, whatever is oppressing our lives, Father Lord, feed them with your flesh. Let them drink their wine, oh God, until they are drunk. Because you have promised to save us and save our children. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Thank you, Father. We give you praise. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Your name is Jesus. Your name is Jesus. You are the miracle working. Your name is Jesus. His name is healer.
His name is Jesus.
Your name is Jesus.
You are the miracle working God. Your name is Jesus. Your name is Jesus. You're a miracle working God. Your name is Jesus.
Do. even according to your word to us this morning, in the name of Jesus. As we go into your word, Father, please expound your words in our hearts. In the name of Jesus. Whatever, oh God, that will stand against your words in our life this morning, we command them to be scattered in the name of Jesus. Give us peace in our hearts. Give us understanding this morning. Open our hearts to salvation. Open our hearts, my Father, to healing. Open our hearts to deliverance. Save souls this morning. Deliver the oppressed this morning. In the name of Jesus. Do something new in our lives this morning. Take us, oh God, to our place of rest this morning. In the name of Jesus. Open every closed womb this morning. Restore every perverted destiny this morning. Everyone that is hopeless, receive hope this morning. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. I say, in Jesus' name, we have prayed. If you know that you have been relocated to that high place, praise the Lord. Give your neighbor a high five and tell him or her, you are settled forever. Say it with confidence. If he's not telling you the way it is, just go back and look for somebody else. So tell your neighbor, you are settled forever. Praise the Lord. Can we quickly open our Bible? Today we are going to pray. We are still going to pray. Now, but quickly we want to look at the word of God. Genesis chapter 17. I'm going to restart reading from verse 1. I will stop where I can. Genesis chapter 17. Genesis chapter 17. I want to start reading from verse 1. This is a story that we are all very, very familiar with. And when Abram was 90 years old and 9, the Lord appeared to Abram. Who appeared unto him? Who appeared unto him? The Lord will appear unto you today in the name of Jesus, and said unto him, I am the Almighty God. Walk before me and be thou perfect. And I will make my covenant between me and thee, and will multiply thee exceedingly. And Abraham fell on his face, and God talked with him, saying, as for me, behold, my covenant is with thee, and thou shalt be a father of many nations. Neither shall thy name any more be called Abram, but thy name shall be Abraham. For a father of many nations have I made thee. There's somebody that is listening this morning. You've been looking up unto the Lord for the fruit of the womb. Your name is about to change. Somebody is going to be called Iya Ibeji. Somebody is going to be called Mama Ibeta. And somebody is going to be called Grandma of Ibeji. If you are the one, let me hear you shout hallelujah. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Verse 6. And I will make thee exceeding fruitful. And I will make nations of thee. And kings shall come out of thee. And I will establish my covenant between me and thee and thy seed after thee in their generations for an everlasting covenant, to be a God unto thee and to thy seed after thee. And I will give unto thee and to thy seed after thee the land which thou art a stranger, all the land of Canaan, for an everlasting possession. And I will be their God. Verse 9. And God said unto Abraham, thou shalt keep my covenant therefore, thou and thy seed after thee in their generations. This is my covenant, which ye shall keep between me and you, and thy seed after thee. Every man child among you shall be what? Shall be what? And ye shall circumcise the flesh of your foreskin, and it shall be a token of the covenant betwixt me and you. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I want to stop there. But something preceded what we have just read. Abraham was tired of the valley. God made him promises in Genesis chapter 12. Up till Genesis chapter 17, where we have just read, there was nothing to show for it. He helped himself. But he knew better than that, because the Bible says that Abraham walked with God and he obeyed God, and it was counted to him as righteousness. He obeyed God. So he knew about God. He knew that God made a promise that was yet to be fulfilled. Therefore, one day, he was tired, like many of us. He said, God, is it this chief servant of my house that is going to take my inheritance? He looked soberly at himself. This month of November, the moment that we hit the Baba month, we begin to have sober reflections of our lives. Do I have a witness? We sit down. We begin to look critically at our lives. There are some questions that we normally ask ourselves. Sometimes we ask, am I where I ought to be? Is this where I ought to be? Do you have a New Year resolution? Then you start to look at yourself. How much of this New Year resolution have I achieved? What was your request from the Lord at the beginning of the year? I'm asking you this question. Answer for yourself. What was your request from the Lord this year? Have you shared the testimony? Where were you in January, spiritually, emotionally, financially, materially, this time last year? What has been your percentage increase to what you had? Even your spiritual temperature, the things that you possess, your emotion, materially, everything. What is your percentage increase from last year? After all, that is what organizations do. What was your target for this year? How much of that target have you achieved this year? Are you closer to God this year than last year? This year is running to an end. This is November. We have only 1 month to go. Are you closer to God than you were last year? I want to ask you another question. How many converts do you have this year? I don't want to talk about since you became a Christian or since you started coming to church. How many converts do you have? How many have you brought to Victory House? Many of you, you come to church, the space in front of you is empty. The space beside you is empty. Do you have any plan? Since January, we've been coming, and we've been seeing it. When we look up on the gallery, don't we see empty spaces? How many converts have you brought to Victory House this year? Then the last question that I want to ask, what has been your contribution to the level of development? I refuse to use the progress of your church or your home. No. The level of development in your family, what has been your contribution? What has been the contribution, your own contribution to the spiritual strength of your family, of your church, and of course, of this nation, Nigeria? What has been your own contribution to the decadence that all of us have been speaking about in Nigeria, in our families, in the church? what has been your own contribution to the progress of this church, to the spiritual temperature of this church. Has your contribution allowed God to move the way that God should move? Abraham asked himself some questions. He was asking God. He said, the time is fast spent. You promised me when I was at the age of 75. Now I am 99. 24 years after, the promises have not materialized. How many times have we sat down to think within ourselves and be restless in our spirit, in our soul, that how far have I gone in life? Am I where my mates are? What is the delay? What is causing the delay? How do I tackle this problem? There are times we come face to face with reality. We stop talking about the devil. Our father's wives, our stepmothers, they are the witch, they are the wizard. But how much have you contributed to the success of their attacks in your life? After all, the Bible says that when you are one with God, you are in the majority. The same devil that we prayed about last year, we are still praying about it this year. The same stepmother that had been afflicting us, that because of her, we ran away from the village. We are still praying about its heart this year. How much of it is your fault? Have you ever sat down to think about it? Have you sat down to think about the promises of God? He said, we shall be the head. We shall not be the tail. How many of us are still serving our junior ones? We must begin to be restless in our spirit. This is the time to think about our lives. And the Bible says that when the time came for Abraham to be delivered, because I know your time of deliverance has come. I say your time of deliverance has come. He says, when the time of Abraham came at the age of 99, after he had messed up, after he had disappointed God. But the day came, like today, somebody is going to experience a new beginning. In the name of Jesus. Just 3 or 4 points that I put down before we go and pray. Number one, it is possible to live a life of unfulfillment. It is possible. It is a possibility to live a life of unfulfillment. Because without Jesus, there is no fulfillment. That's why John 10:10 says, that part, the first part, he says, there's nothing in this world. It belongs to the devil. And the devil has come to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But whenever we allow Jesus into our lives, he said we will live a life much more than conqueror. We will have life in its abundance. A life that does not affect other people's lives. A life that does not bring down the glory of God. A life that does not honor God is a life that is wasted. I noticed that I didn't say that a life, whoever is not a millionaire, that's not what I'm saying. A life that does not allow the glory of God to radiate, it's a wasted life. So it is possible, it is a possibility. After all, Abraham lived from 75 years to 99. He made human effort. He got the best of human effort. And the best of human effort is Ishmael. And he's the troubler of the world. He still went and attacked them in France. They are still attacking even this nation, Nigeria. That was the best of human efforts. The best of human efforts in our homes. My wife is this. Therefore, you go for another. You are looking for trouble. My husband is this. You go look for another. You are looking for trouble. My bank account is not buoyant enough. You start to change figures. You are looking for trouble. the person that took us the prayer, opening prayer, he said, when we are living in sin, it's a time bomb about to explode. It must explode. Because God is a God of times and seasons. Whatsoever a man sow, that he shall reap. Galatians 6:7. It is already written in the Bible. Nobody can change it. Praise the Lord. Abraham forgot totally that a man can receive nothing except it be given to him from heaven. John 3:27. John 3:27. Even the children of Israel, they were living unfulfilled life in the land of Egypt. In Exodus 3:7-9, the Lord says, I have surely seen the affliction of my people. They were afflicted. They were crying. They were under the yoke of a taskmaster, like many of us. We are under the yoke of a taskmaster, under the yoke of sin and sinful life. Many of us, we have become slaves to sin. Some of us, if we don't smoke a cigarette in a day, that day is not completed. If we don't drink alcohol in a day, that day has not started. Some people, if you don't fornicate in one day, that is not a good day. Or we don't commit adultery. Or we don't lie in a day. Especially market people. I'm only gaining 1 naira over and above what I bought. It's so easy to come out. You say, buy from me. My gain, my profit is 1 naira. Whereas it is not so. We exchange things that are not correct. We call it the original. Whereas we know that we only painted the back of the thing so that it will be new. And we are Christians. No. We are under the yoke of the taskmaster. One day, it is a time bomb. It must explode. Praise the Lord. Let's rush. Number two. If the Lord does not remember a man, if God does not remember a man, that man will be in the pit of forgetfulness forever. If God does not remember a man, he will remain in the pit of forgetfulness forever. It happened to Joseph. Joseph even did well for that butler. But he did not remember. As he was going out of prison, Joseph said, please, remember me when it is good for you. But when the man got home, he forgot. Genesis chapter 40, verse 23. He said, yet did not the butler, the chief butler, remember Joseph. But what? Read it now, it's on the... What? He forgot. He did not remember Joseph. He forgot him. I pray that the Lord will remember you today. In the name of Jesus. If God did not remember Abraham, imagine, it is Eliezer that would have been the heir to everything that he had. But that is not so. Genesis chapter 15, verse 1. When Abraham kept bugging God, say, is this what is going to be my portion? Verse 1. After these things, the word of the Lord came unto Abraham in a vision. I say the word of the Lord will locate you. The word of the Lord will locate you. He said, fear not. Tell your neighbor, fear not. I am thy shield and thy exceeding great reward. And God is telling somebody, I am your shield and your exceeding great reward. Praise the Lord. In the advanced age of 99, God still remembered Abraham. God will remember you. I said, God will never come for you too late. God will never come for you too late. In the name of Jesus. Abraham also had lost hope. Are you here? You have lost hope. There is a God in heaven. He never forgets his own. Say, I will never leave you. I will never forsake you. No matter how painful your experience may be, the promises of God, they stand forever. Is your exceeding great reward. In the name of Jesus, the all-sufficient God will locate you. He can never, never fail. 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 Jesus. I hope you remember which Sunday we are even talking here today. Today is Breakthrough Sunday. Do you know? Today is Breakthrough Sunday. I want you to tell your neighbor, I am breaking forth. I am going to cross that line in the name of Jesus. And then that song that says, I shall not fail. I shall not fail. Because of Jesus, I shall not fail. Number three, there is a solution to every challenge. There is a solution. No matter how you know it looks, forget it. There is a solution to every challenge. No matter how big, no matter how naughty, no matter how it looks, no matter how hopeless it looks, have you messed up in life? The moment you come on the side of the Lord, I want to assure you that there is a solution. In the name of Jesus. I say there is a solution. In the name of Jesus. Exodus chapter 2, verse 23 to 25. Exodus chapter 2, verse 23 to 25. And it came to pass in the process of time that the king of Egypt died, and the children of Israel sighed by reason of the bondage. And they cried, and their cry came up unto God by reason of the bondage. And God heard their groaning. And God remembered his covenant with Abraham, with Isaac, and with Jacob. And God looked upon the children of Israel and had respect unto them. The Lord will have respect unto you. I say your groaning will be heard in heaven. The Almighty God will arise to your cry in the name of Jesus. No wonder Mary declared, he said, for with God, nothing shall be impossible. Luke chapter 1 verse 37 and Jeremiah chapter 32 verse 17. Jeremiah chapter 17 verse 32. Jeremiah chapter 32 verse 17. Jeremiah cried. He said, ha, Lord God, is this how you are? He said, behold, you made the heavens and the earth by your great power and outstretched arm, and there's nothing too hard for thee. Jeremiah chapter 32 verse 17. Number four, say God's promises cannot fail. What did I say? God's promises cannot fail. Exodus chapter 19, 5 to 6. Now therefore, if you will obey my voice indeed and keep my covenant, then it shall be a peculiar treasure unto me above all people, for all the earth is mine. And ye shall be unto me a kingdom of priests, a holy nation. These are the words which thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel. And I'm speaking it into the children of Victory House. I say the promises of God concerning your life, it shall not fail. I say it shall not fail. In the name of Jesus. God made the promises to the children of Israel when they were in the land of Babylon. They were by the riverside. They were crying. They were weeping. There was no solution to their problem. But a day came, and they declared with their mouth. They sang the song that when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, they said they were like one of them that dream. Why? Because in Jeremiah chapter 29, from verse 8 to 10, God promised them. He said that they are going to spend 72 years, that after 70 years has passed, that surely he will visit them. And the Lord visited them. The Lord will visit you this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Quickly, what are we supposed to do? Number one, we must drop our anchor in Jesus Christ. He's the rock. we must drop our anchor. That's the first thing to do. We must drop our anchor. And that is our faith. Our anchor is our faith in Jesus Christ. It is our hope that we stand against every form of attack from wherever, any form of challenge. That means, very simple, we must never be ashamed to bend our knees in prayers. We must not be ashamed to bend our knees in prayers. We are used to seeking God in bad times. We forget to pray when things are going right. God requires consistency. Nehemiah chapter 4 and verse 14. Write it down. We are out of time. Number two, we must be a witness to the Lord. We must be a credible witness of the Lord, of the goodness of the Lord to the people. God keeps looking for a man. That's why he said in Mark chapter 16 from verse 15 to 18, he said we should go and preach the gospel. If we had preached to the Boko Haram people, they will not be killing us now. He said we have the power, the ability to cast out those devils in them, and they will obey without looking back. He said he has given us the power to tread down upon the wicked, upon every power of the wicked. He said they will be like ashes under the soles of our feet. Malachi chapter 4 from verse 2. Malachi chapter 4 from verse 2. So those are the promises of God for our lives. We must drop our anchor with him. We must have faith. And we must be a credible witness unto the Lord. Brethren, the Lord will not touch a sinner with a long arm. No. I want us finally, and that's where we are going to pray. Used to pray. Genesis chapter 21. From verse 9 to 12. Genesis chapter 21. Verse 9 to 12. And Sarah saw the son of Hagar, the Egyptian, which she had borne unto Abraham, mocking. Wherefore she said unto Abraham, cast out this bondwoman and her son, for the son of this bondwoman shall not be here with my son, even with Isaac. Is there anybody in our midst this morning? I know you are here. You want to become Isaac, but right now you are Ishmael. And Jesus is saying that he will not give his inheritance to the son of the bondwoman. He said no. That is the reason why he came. So that he can bring us out of darkness into the place of righteousness. And the simple thing that Sarah said, he said, cast him out. Don't allow him to be where I am, because Isaac is the promise of God. He said, it is not going to be to happen. So it is only Isaac that has the promise of God. Verse 10. Wherefore she said unto Abraham, cast out this bondwoman and her son, for the son of this bondwoman shall not be here with my son, even with Isaac. Verse 11. And the thing was very grievous in Abraham's sight because of his son. It is not easy to cut off sin. So Abraham, it was grievous. But listen to what God said. And God said unto Abraham, let it not be grievous in thy sight because of the Lord, because of thy bondwoman, in all that Sarah has said unto thee. Hearken unto her voice, for in Isaac shall thy seed be called. For in what? Read it all. For in Isaac, in who shall the seed be called? The promises of God will only be found in Isaac, not in Ishmael. Are you here? You are not born again. There's no way that the inheritance of God will reach you. No. It is not about discriminating, but it is about the word of God that is settled forever. So I want us to stand up this morning because I want us to pray. We are going to use that passage to pray. Who is a bondwoman? it is the slavery to sin. Slavery to sin. And he said, the son of this bondwoman, the son of Hagar, that is the product of our sin, the product of sinful life, of unbelief, the consequences of do it yourself, that is the son of Hagar. He said, must be cast out. Why? Because he's mocking Isaac. And what is it to mock? It is to attack, to challenge, to treat with ridicule, to treat with contempt. You are going to pray this morning. When something is mocking, it is struggling with our inheritance in Christ. Whatever is struggling with your inheritance in Christ this morning, you must cut it off. Choir, please. Come up and sing for us. You are going to sing that chorus. Lord, lift me up to the higher plane. A higher plane than I have found. Lord, plant my feet upon the higher ground. And if you are here, you are not born again. And you are still looking back. You are wondering, how will your story end? Your story can end in one good way, when you identify with Christ. Therefore, this morning, I urge you, come to meet with Jesus. He will change your story, I can assure you. He will surely change your story. He changed this. God bless you. God bless you. Keep coming. He changed the story of Abraham. He changed his name from that time. That is the reason why you and I, we can cry unto the Lord. And the blessings of Abraham is our own. God bless you. Please don't cheat yourself this morning. Choir, please. Lord, lift me up and let me stand. By faith on earth, no stable land, I am plain, now I have found, Lord, that's my faith on higher ground. Brethren, it is not an ordinary hymn, it is a prayer. It is also a desire. But you see, a desire, a wish, a hope must be accompanied by action. It is when you support it with action that things will begin to happen. So support this song that you are singing with your action by taking the step of faith and coming to join up with Jesus here. He's the only one that can lift you up onto higher plane. While the choir is singing, begin to come. And we are going to start praying. Choir, please.
Lord, lift me up.
Lift up your two hands unto the Lord and sing it with meaning in your heart. Come. Jesus wants you to be lifted, to be planted. Tell the devil to leave you alone.
Lord, plant my feet on
Lord, lift me up.
Lord, lift me up.
Come and join us here. This morning, the woman said, cast out this bond woman and her son. There must be no fellowship and no share in my inheritance. What is mocking God in your destiny? What is mocking God in your marriage, in your ministry? They must be cast out this morning. Whatever is mocking, challenging the authority of God in our life, challenging the promises and causing delay, bringing tears into our life, whatever is standing against the purpose of God for our life, those things must be cast away this morning. In the name of Jesus, lift up your voice and say, Father, Father, whatever is mocking my destiny, my marriage, my fruitfulness, whatever is causing delay of your promises concerning my life, I cast them out. I cast them out. Whatever represents the bond woman, slavery to sin, whatever that I am doing that I am not able to live, and I know it is unrighteous life, whatever is mocking my God, whatever is blocking the favor of God in my life, whatever it is that is wrong that I'm doing, that I know causing pain, whatever we are struggling under, Father, today I cast them out. I cast them out. Let there be a separation today. In the name of Jesus, every stranger in my life, every stranger in my body, that agent of death in my body, whatever I'm struggling with in my business, in my marriage, in my family, in the church, in our nation, every stranger occupying the place of God in my life, I cast them out in the name of Jesus. Every mocker of my life, Lord, I cast them out. I cast out the bond woman and her son from my life in the name of Jesus. I cast out the delay. Every delay that is mocking the promises of God, begin to cry unto the Lord. They must be destroyed. They must be cast out in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Everything that must not be found in our life as a Christian, as a child of God, every Ishmael that is occupying the place of Isaac in my life, in my home, in my marriage, in my business, in my ministry, in the church, Lord, I cast them out today in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. The Bible says that even if with our open eyes we have walked into captivity, he said there's a provision for us in Isaiah chapter 49, verse 24. Isaiah chapter 49, verse 24. He says, Isaiah chapter 49, verse 24. Shall the prey be taken from the mighty, or the lawful captive delivered? He said, but thus saith the Lord, even the captives of the mighty shall be taken away, and the prey of the terrible shall be delivered. Why? He said, I will contend with him that contendeth with thee, and I will save their children, and I will feed them that oppress you with their own flesh, and they shall be drunken with their own blood as with sweet wine. And all flesh, all members of your family, all the people in your community, everyone that knows you, they will know that I, the Lord, I am your Savior and your Redeemer, the mighty one of Jacob. Brethren, there's a power that can set us free from the legal ground and the foothold of the devil in our lives. There is a power that can break evil covenants and launch us into that purpose of God for our lives. He said he will contend. I want us to lift up our voices. Some of our children are into drugs and alcohol, and it is perverting their destinies. I want us to lift up our voices and say, Father, Father, every power claiming legal ground in our lives, in the name of Jesus, contend with them. Contend with them. In the name of Jesus, all our children that are given to drugs and alcohol, all our children that are given to perverted life, Almighty God, today, the power to deliver them. Father, we receive you today. In the name of Jesus, we declare freedom. We declare freedom unto our children. In the name of Jesus, we decree freedom. Freedom. Every power, oh God, contending with us, contending with our home, contending with our marriages, contending with our fruitfulness. Lord, today, the power to deliver. Father, release unto us the power to set us free. Release unto us in the name of Jesus. Father, contend with the power, contending with our season of rest, with our season of harvest. In the name of Jesus, whatever is making our heads to be bowed, Almighty God, oh, Father, contend with them. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, our Father. We give you praise. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. As I go, are you here this morning? You've been waiting on the Lord for the fruit of the womb. Put your hand on your stomach. Do you have ailments in your body? I want you to put your hand on it. Is there something that you are asking God to do for you, and he's not done it, and this is November, and you've been praying about it? Lift up your hand up. If you are looking for the fruit of the womb, put your hand on your stomach. If you are sick and afflicted, put your hand where that problem is. And if your desire is for something, you need a breakthrough, I want you to lift up your hand as I make this declaration. In the name of Jesus, our Father and our God, we give you praise. We thank you this morning because we know you are here. It is in your name, O God, that I declare your word. In Isaiah chapter 49, from verse 24, the Bible says that thus saith the Lord, that even the captives of the mighty shall be taken away, and the prey of the terrible shall be delivered. Our Father that is in heaven, everyone, O God, that is in the captivity of a mighty one, the captivity of generational curse and ancestral covenant, groaning under the weight of yoke, of affliction, of barrenness, by your word this morning that says, thus saith the Lord, be free in the name of Jesus. Be free in the name of Jesus. I said, be free in the name of Jesus. Father, contend with every power that is contending with the fruitfulness in the life of your children. Every power contending with divine health in the lives of your children. Father, contend with them in the name of Jesus. Almighty God, as many as are under oppression, as many, oh God, that has been depressed because of issues of life, as many homes that are groaning and crying and mourning, Almighty God, the Bible says, thus saith the Lord, Father, let there be a release of your mercy today upon such lives in the name of Jesus. Every troubled home, receive your deliverance today in the name of Jesus. Said, I will upbeat them that oppress you with their own flesh. Father in heaven, you said the purpose is for the manifestation of your power. Father, we stand upon your word today. As many as are looking up unto you for one miracle or the other, that are looking for solution, and they are trusting you, they have dropped their anchor. Their faith is in you, Almighty God. Father, set them free from every bondage, of lack, of want, in the name of Jesus. Let the world know that you are our Redeemer. let the world know that you are our God. In the name of Jesus, as many as are here, my Father, my God, who are crying and weeping because of issues of life, Father, begin to put laughter in our mouths in the name of Jesus. Father, put laughter in our mouths in the name of Jesus. Let our season of joy come. Let today be our morning of joy. Our morning of joy has come. Oh, Father, we thank you. Forever we will praise you. Forever we will praise you. We thank you, our Father. We give you praise. And for these, your children who have come to set themselves in agreement with your word, they have come out of being Ishmael to becoming Isaac. The Bible says it was in the time of famine that Isaac planted, and he reaped many, many fold returns until he became the envy of the Philistines. Father, I decree into the lives of your children that as they have identified with you, with a promise in their hearts that they will not go back to their vomit, Lord, make them exceedingly great in the name of Jesus. Let them become the envy of their enemies in the name of Jesus. Let them never go back to their sin in the name of Jesus. And for all of us, December is coming. The year is running to an end. Almighty God, every good remaining in the part of this year, every goodness, every blessing that remains in this year, Father, direct them to our lives in the name of Jesus. Take away from us every evil. Take away from us every calamity. Take away from us every accident, every air crash. In the name of Jesus, we shall not be victims. We shall be victorious in the name of Jesus. Father, let our breakthrough be assured. We are moving into our breakthrough. We are lifting up our, we are lifted up to stand upon a higher ground. Father, we will never come down in the name of Jesus. Thank you, our Father. We give you praise. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. I want somebody who believes that the Lord has settled her grace to shout a wonderful hallelujah to the Lord.